Start with any image in Affinity Photo, then go to Filters, and then Colors, and down to Halftone. Now at this point, you see what happens. You end up with a black and white halftone effect, which is pretty good. There's also other options. Of course, there's color. There's also line, variety of different ones you can use. Now I'm going to go with monochrome. Now, unfortunately, there is no color option here, which is a pity. How to get around that? Well, what you can do, you can always go, click apply there. I can add some color. You can see color there. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to go to layer and new fill. And I've got white there. Well, I don't want white, I want red. So I double click on there, just over there, and it can bring up the color, and you can just change the color. Now at this point, you can't see anything, because of course it's, now what you could do, you could change opacity, and you can get a nice effect like that. It's one option. Also, you can go through blending modes, maybe go for darken, lighten, linear burn, maybe screen. Just try them out. You don't have to keep it fixed, so you can always change your mind later. So what you can also do is you can select both of those. So both selected in here, layers, you can find that in view and studio and layers. Now I can go and group those. So going there, just go to group, that's right clicking there and brings up, they're both grouped now. Well, I can change the colors. I don't have to just have red. So I can go over here to this one and I can duplicate it. So there and duplicate, that's just right click and then duplicate. So I can expand that one out. So red, I can go for blue. Now I always do that, I don't want to do that, double click that, doesn't have any effect whatsoever other than not get the image in the way that I want. What I want to do is go over here, just used to doing that in Photoshop. You double click and you can change the color. Now you can't do that in Affinity Photo. Double click over here, just over here, and change the color, and then you can make that blue. And then of course what you do, I'm just going to go view again just to make it 100%, so you can just see it. So now it's just obviously a group again, exactly the same as there, but I can change the blend modes for that. I can go over here and I can go say darken or color burn, linear burn. But what you can also do is just a layer, just a standard layer. Okay, it's a group, but it's a layer all the same. You can just move it, just shift it slightly or resize it just slightly. Doesn't have to be a massive. You don't want to go massive because then you end up, you won't see the image particularly well. And obviously you'll lose that tree there, that pole there, etc., the road. You can see now you've got two colors there instead of, now of course you've got the option for color, but I don't think that it gives a lot of color, but this, you can just limit it to a range of just reds and blues. Or if you want, you can always do it again. So you just simply go over here, right click again, and duplicate. With this duplicated, you can just go there, again, select that. Don't double click it, unless you want to double click it. Go over here to change the color. I say, I just do it too easily, just double click and expect it to change. Now it's green, so I've got green. Now obviously that's overlapping the blue, so you can't see the blue, but you get this nice, actually that's quite nice, that one. Red and green, obviously it always works well. But I've got red, green, and I want blue. So I want the blue back. So I'm just going to go up here again to the group. And again, it's just a layer, basically a standard layer. And I can just shift it just slightly. And I can just shift either round, any of them round. And again, I can change blend modes. I can run through experiment, just try different combinations. Sometimes you get one, you think, you know what, that looks brilliant. Or not. Maybe that one. And this one with the green. And so on and so on. You just try them out. Doesn't mean that you're going to get the right one first time around. You've got a slight bit of blue there. Again, you can move that. Just shift it around. Maybe resize it. You can also apply effects. So you could just go to here. Maybe you don't want to affect in terms of completely destroying, because this is, would be a destructive effect. What you can do, you can always go to layer and new fill layer there, live filter layer, and go to blur and Gaussian blur. So Gaussian blur is applied to that. And I can just double click there and bring that up, and I can just blur it. Preserve alpha there. Then you can just change it. So instead of having a nice, you can see now there's a slight blur to this. And you do the same for the other ones if you want to do that. And of course, there's also the option, because no, I haven't done it. You go to layer and new live filter layer, colors, there's the half tone there as well. So you can combine it. So you've got this effect. Now you can put that right at the top. So you can go over here, layer, go to new live filter layer, colors and half tone. And you can see what happens. You end up with the effect there. And again, you change that. Of course, now you've just got black and white again, but you can see what's happened. You've actually, instead of just got the standard halftone effect, you've actually got an introduction of a slightly variant halftone effect here, where you've got sort of like square design there. And of course, you've also got blending modes and opacity. So if you decide, you know what, let's just bring in some of the color, you can see now you've got the green there, or maybe go for blending modes and you can run through the blending modes. Some will work, some will won't. Maybe go for that, change the angle and so on. Just try them out. And as always with these things, because it's a live effect, you can always remove it. So it's gone, doesn't have any effect now. And that's it, just run through. And you can create all kinds of different color combinations with these dots. You don't have to use just the color effect to create that. Hope you found this of interest. A dislike or like, always appreciated. Thank you much.